Hello, my dear students. We will continue our discussion. As discussed in the previous class, we have understood what are the primary variables, what are the secondary variables, what we mean by dimensional homogeneity, the MLT terms on the left hand side of the equation and right hand side of the equation remains the same. We have three similarities between the model and the actual. They are called geometric similarity, kinematic similarity and dynamic similarity. Beyond that discussion is non-dimensional parameter. So we will now see this dimensionless number. As I mentioned earlier, these dimensionless numbers are derived to correlate a physical phenomenon independent of their units. It means these dimensionless numbers, which are m to power 0, L to power 0 and T to power 0, are dimensionless. We will take a very important one. First one, Reynolds number. Reynolds number is very important in closed flows. It could be AC duct, it could be Cauvery pipeline or pipeline in your home. The Reynolds number is a number. You can see now a term, we call it number. Why we call number? Because it is a dimensionless. So the Reynolds is the person who derived this number. He says, definition, it is the ratio of inertia force to the viscous force. If this ratio is measured, it is called a Reynolds number. Normally, if you calculate Reynolds number less than 2000, we say laminar, 2000 to 4000 transition, and beyond 4000, normally most of the industries are having the turbulent region only. Reynolds number is of the order of 10 to power 4, 10 to power 5, 10 to power 6, even more than that. But some of the liquids, like you can say ghee, or you can say a viscous liquid like honey, if it flows, it will not flow that fast. In that case, it will follow laminar number or less than 2000. But air, if you take the flow of air, Reynolds number is of the order of 10 to power 7, 8 and more. So this is the first dimension. Rho stands for density, V stands for velocity, D stands for the diameter of the pipeline or size of the duct. So rho stands for density. Rho is mass density. V is the velocity. D is the diameter. So, and mu is the coefficient of dynamic viscosity. Now you may be thinking, okay sir, we understood Reynolds number is a very important number. It takes the ratio of the inertia force to viscous force. What is its importance? As I explained, if I have a Cauvery pipeline of 1 meter diameter which brings the water to Bangalore, I want to simulate in my laboratory, I will take only 1 centimeter pipeline. So 1 meter, 1 centimeter ratio is 1:100. I want to study the Cauvery pipeline in my lab, which is called model, M. M stands for model. As I told you earlier also, M stands for model. And P stands for actual prototype. It means the Cauvery pipeline here will be 1 meter and here model 1 centimeter. So you understood what is the meaning of prototype, What is the meaning of model? So if I say the Reynolds number should be same between the actual Kaveri pipeline and the model in my lab, I will now compare. You see here, we say density rho m into Vm dm by mu m. This is for model. This is for model. And this is for actual. They should be equal to each other. So, my dear friends, if I say that Reynolds number similarity is there, it's a kinematic similarity. So, density of the model into velocity of the model into diameter divided by the viscosity is equal to density of the prototype, velocity of the prototype, diameter of the prototype divided by dynamic viscosity. This is called Reynolds similarity. Let us take one more. Fraud's number is very important for open channel flow. It is basically a gravity flow. If there is a Kaveri river flowing, the river will flow from the Tarakaveri to the Bay of Bengal. It is going this side totally because of the elevation difference. The elevation on the Tarakaveri may be, you can say, 1 kilometer, 1000 meter above MSL, and when it joins sea, the difference is zero. So it is flowing with a difference of 1000 meters, correct? And the length may be, you know very well, 800 kilometer or 900 kilometer, whatever it travels. So the Fraud number similarity is very important. It says velocity of the model divided by square root of the length into g. G cancels normally because both are same. So we can say Vm by square root Lm and Vp by square root Lp. This is called Fraud's model, normally used for open channel flow. Okay, mind it well. Normally we use it for open channel. Open channel. So I discussed two important ones. One is the Reynolds model for pipe flow, Fraud's model for the open channel. We'll see others also. Reynolds number is there also in open channel, not like that, but the significance is less. Let's see next one. Let us see one more number called Euler number. This Euler number is again a ratio. It is the ratio of the inertia to the pressure force. You can see V by P, square root of P by rho. P is the intensity of pressure, V is the velocity. Intensity of pressure normally we measure in Pascals, and density of the liquid. So if you calculate this way, it calculates the Euler number. So we can also use it for our model and the prototype. Next one. Now I would like to now do an experiment in my lab with the help of, say, Kaveri pipeline. I want to derive some non-dimensional numbers. I think you know very well what is a non-dimensional number whose dimensions are m to power 0, l to power 0 and t to power 0. What are the methods available? This method is a very old method, which is called Rayleigh method. Rayleigh method, it says that dimensional analysis is expressed as a functional relationship in the form of exponential equation. Make a note, in the form of exponential equation. We have a dependent variable and we have an independent variable. You may be thinking, what is that? I will explain. Y is equal to function of x1, x2, x3. My dear friends, y is a dependent variable. Y is a dependent variable. I will repeat, it is depending on x1, x2 and x3. X1 variable is independent. It could be age of the person. X2, it could be height of the person. X3 may be blood group. Y is that particular person. Definitely, whatever I am trying to describe, y becomes independent. So y is a dependent variable. and these are all independent variables. Is it okay? So, for the relay method, when I apply, I am going to put in the exponential form of this y as a function of e to power x1, e to power x2, something like that. Okay? So, this is the relay method. It says that r is a function of c is a constant, r1 to the power a, r2 to the power b, r3 to the power c. So, these dimensions I need to derive. Is it okay? Now, we will solve this equation based on that particular physics. For example, if it is a velocity, I know it is L by T. If it is a density, I know it is a L by T cube. Okay? So, anything you take density, mass by L cube. So, surface tension, force per unit length. Like that, we will derive those dimension and get the answer. Let us see next one. Now, let us take an example. Now, my dear friends, you can make a note, we are going to solve a problem based on the relay method. Relay method, I will take the first problem. The velocity of sound C in air varies as bulk modulus of elasticity. The velocity of sound C in air varies as bulk modulus of elasticity K and mass density rho. Derive an expression for velocity in the form of C is equal to, I think it is not coming, C is equal to square root K by rho. Right? Now, I am giving you some dimensions. Number one, velocity. Number two, bulk modulus. Number three, density. I will write now. First one is mass density. Okay? We will calculate. So, I think m to power 1. Velocity L m to power 0, L to power 1, T to power minus 1. Bulk modulus, I will take L to power minus 1, m to power 0, T to power minus 2. Mass density, m to power 1, L to power minus 3 and T to power 0. So, these are the basic dimensions. We will take it. First, we will form a group, step 1. We say C is equal to S into K to power A, rho to power B. A and B are unknown. Okay? C is a function of constant S, bulk modulus K and density rho. Now, I will substitute. S is a constant. Step 2, left hand side. You can see it is a velocity. What is velocity? Everybody knows velocity is L by T. What is that? L T minus 1. Minus 1. So, m to power 0, L to power 1, T to power 1, minus 1. Is it okay? Now, this is your C. Okay? Now, what I will do, I would like to take on right hand side, S is a constant. You can see this equation, S is a constant. Equation 1, we are writing equation 1. K to power A, L to power minus 1, M to power 0, T to power minus 2. To the power A, you can see power A, power A. Density, m to power 1, m to power 1, L to power minus 3. M to power 1, L to power minus 3, T is not there. We will calculate that. Based on this, we will compare. Now, when we compare the values, we will get these values of A and B. Is it okay? Now, this method which I discussed, which is called relay method, has got some limitations. Normally, it is not being used by any scientist now. It is there now as a one of the method. The limitations are, number one, the relay method is adopted when number of parameters or variables are less than 5. You can see this is a limitation. More than that, if I go, I cannot use this method. It is not recommended. Second thing, method is not telling any systematic approach. There is no systematic approach, okay, to establish relationship. So, we will not recommend this. Second thing is, it is not recommended now for dimensional analysis. Nowadays, we are not using this method for dimensional analysis. Okay, we will take next one. Now, more popular method is Buckingham's pi method. Buckingham pi method says we have to first get the n number of variables. N can be anything. It may be 20, it may be 30, it may be 5, it may be 6, whatever you say. It is actually the independent n variable, all variables together, n variables. Okay, maybe 7 or say 12, whatever number you say. Okay, and depends on m fundamental dimension. My dear friends, our fundamental dimensions are primary quantities. I repeat, Buckingham pi theorem, which talks, it takes n number of variables. M is a primary dimension. M normally it is a m, l and t, it becomes 3, right? Mind it well, our m value is 3, n can be 7, n can be 5 or it may be whatever it is. Okay, it says that x1, x2 are variables. We can give this function in the form of a equal to 0, whatever number of variables are there. For example, it is a function of say 20 variable, x1 to x20, I will put equal to 0. Okay, so my dear friends, you can see we will get pi terms. What is the pi term? If number of variables are 7, if say n equal to 7 and m is actually 3, what is n minus m? Can you calculate? If you calculate, it is 7 minus 3, it is equal to 4. We can say it will be having 4 pi terms, pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 and pi 4. I repeat, any n number of variables can be taken in the Buckingham pi theorem, right? M is the dependent variable, okay? Any number, n. M is actually primary variable. What is that? M, L, T, they are 3. So subtract n minus m, say 7 minus 3 or 8 minus 3, whatever it is. So we can calculate those pi numbers. Next one, we will first write the functional relationship with the given data, which is called step number 1. Make a note, it is the step number 1. We will first write the fundamental equation. Second one, then write the equation in its general form, which is actually, I told you, say function of x1 dash 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 up to say x20 is equal to 0. This is called general form, correct? Third is choose 3 repeating variables. Now I am coming to implementation. He is saying that choose repeating variable. What is the meaning? As the name says, it is going to repeat in all the formulae, which is called repeating variables. Okay, one repeating variable I will take from flow property, one we will take from geometry. Flow means we can take velocity, geometry I can take length, one is the fluid property, can be density, anything. I am giving an example. You can take here pressure, no problem. You can take here diameter, no problem. You can take here surface tension or any other property, no problem. Q, discharge also you can take. With the help of principle of dimension homogeneity, find out the values of A, B, C. It means we are now applying the dimensional analysis in the right form. So mind it well, once you get say pi 1, pi 2, pi 3, pi 4, you can put in a functional form and get the answer. So this particular theorem, which is called Buckingham pi theorem, is very, very useful. Okay, so we are going to see how we are going to do this. Let us take one example. My dear students, we are going to take one example on Buckingham pi theorem. The drag force on a sphere depends on 4 parameters. The drag force on a sphere, for example, a sphere is there of say diameter d and there is a flow. No doubt there will be a drag. Fd will be there, drag force. Okay, it will be dragging the sphere in a force way. So we would like to say it depends on speed v, the velocity of this fellow, fluid density, what is the density of this fellow, viscosity mu, and diameter d of this particular sphere. These are the four parameters. I repeat, drag force on a sphere FD on four parameter. First one is diameter, next is the speed, next is the density and dynamic viscosity mu. Obtain the non-dimensional form using the Buckingham Pi theorem. Right? First equation you can see F is equal to, I put function of D diameter, velocity V, density rho and mu. Repeat, these are the four parameters given here, you can see here. Right? I am taking, what is this force? Drag force is here, F. Right? So, F is equal to function of F of D comma rho comma V and mu. List all the dimension parameters involved. Let n be the number of parameters for drag, a sphere, all those things. You can see n is now 5. This is number 1, this is number 2, this is number 3, this is number 4 and this is number 5. So, what is your n? N value is 5. Is it okay? Repeat, F drag force number 1, diameter of the sphere 2, velocity 3, density of the liquid or the air 4, viscosity of the fluid 5. Right? So, these are the n equal to 5. Let us take next one. Now, primary dimensions, force is equal to mass into acceleration, the main parameter, m to the power mLt minus 2. Then diameter, it is the length parameter, mass density m to power 1 l to power cube, because it is mass by volume. Right? Then dynamic viscosity m to power 1 l to power minus 1 t to power minus 1. You can derive from this formula. Tau is equal to mu into du by dy is the Newton's law of viscosity. From this you can derive this. Okay? Then velocity. Velocity is nothing but lt minus 1. Lt minus 1. Now you can see it is depending on m, it is depending on l and it is depending on t. It means our m value is 3. N value was 5. You remember? N value was 5. So we say 5 minus 3, 2 pi terms will come into picture. 2 pi terms will come. Number 1, f is a function of pi 1 and pi 2 equal to 0. Equation number 2. It means we are able to derive the equation now based on this fundamental. What is that? Total number of variables. This is total. This is the primary. What is primary? What is primary? MLT. MLT, which is 3. Right? So you can see total is 5. Total is 5. And m is 3, so we even get 2 pi terms. Now, once you calculate this one, selecting the repeating variable, I will take density from the liquid property, 1 from the fluid property, 1 from the flow property, which is velocity. You can see I am selecting 1 from the fluid property, 1 from the flow property, and you can say 1 from the geometry. So, 3 I am taking and I am putting in the term pi 1 is equal to rho to power a 1. It is going to repeat. Velocity is going to repeat v to power b 1 d to power c 1 into function f, that is the force. Pi 2 is equal to again repeating rho to power a 2 v to power b 2 and d to power c 2 into dynamic viscosity. So, it means I am able to make the pi terms 2 pi terms based on these 5 variables. Correct? So, 5 variable, in that 3 I am repeating. 3 I am repeating. Other 2 are, one is the force, other is the dynamic viscosity. So, you can see here pi 1 is equal to rho to power a 1, to power b1 d to power c1 force under drag, drag force pi 2 rho to power a2 v to power b2 d to power c2 mu. Definitely we are going to now analyze one by one. We will take pi 1 like here, and here we are going to equate. Pi is a constant. You can see pi 1 is constant, m to power 0, l to power 0 and t to power 0. I will substitute density m by l cube, velocity l by t cube, diameter length. So this I will compare and get pi 1 is equal to f by rho vd square. Similarly pi 2 is here only, you can see pi 2 is equal to rho to power a2 v to power b2 d to power c2 into viscosity. This pi 2 is constant, pi 2 is m to power 0, l to power 0 and t to power 0. Substitute m by l cube to power a2, velocity l by t b2, diameter l to power c2, viscosity m l minus 1 t minus 1. If you solve this, you will get pi 2 is equal to rho vd by mu. These two terms are getting into picture. It means we will get total number of terms n as 5, primary variable as 3, pi terms are 2. So function of pi 1 into pi 2 equal to 0. 3 repeating variable, one from the fluid property, one from the flow property, one from the geometry. So once you have these 3, we will get rho to power a1, v to power b1, d to power c1 into drag force. Again rho to power a2, rho v to power b2, d to power c2 into dynamic viscosity. Substitute their dimension for density, mass by l cube to power a2, velocity l by t to power b2, diameter l to power c2, m l minus 1 t minus 1 is the dimension for viscosity. So compare these terms, mass, powers of mass m, powers of l, powers of t, and get those answers. So this is the way we calculate the relationship using the Buckingham algorithm. So in this case you can see this is the pi 1 function of pi 2, or pi 2 as a function of pi 1, whatever you say. So this is the way you can see nicely we are able to derive the drag force depends upon these numbers. This can be tested in a wind tunnel, or this can be tested in water tunnel, and this relationship can be established, right? So with this first part of the session, which I covered the dimension analysis, is complete, in which we have covered the primary variable, secondary variable, dimensional homogeneity, dimensionless numbers, geometric similarity, kinematic similarity and dynamic similarity. We also discussed two methods with the help of dimensionless numbers. We can derive these equations for Rayleigh method and Buckingham pi method. Thank you.